We are kicking off here on the Hake Report, guys. And we're going on, kicking it on IG. Looks like it's going to kick on for, yes, indeed, on YouTube. Yes. It is Tuesday, April 2nd, AD 2024, right? Yeah. 9:01 a.m. U.S. Pacific Daylight time here in Los Angeles. Trying to bring my guy over here. I want to show off my pro-Semitic octopus. I love the Semites. I love all people. If I love anybody. It is, we're going to have a fun show, guys. We'll take your calls if you'd like to call in. Some of you guys I did not get to. 1-888-775-3773. I'm excited to cover some of the stuff that's coming up. Let me make sure my stuff is muted. What will we cover today? Well, you know, there was a Finnish shooting. I didn't really plan to talk a lot about that, if at all. But poor Finland. Well, poor 12-year-old who got killed. And poor 12-year-old who shot the 12-year-old and injured many others. I wanted to elaborate a little bit more on a coffee that was bought me. You can buy a coffee. You can do super chats for Hake, guys. Buymeacoffee.com/thehakereport. And I'll read them, okay? Or Ko-fi, coffee, ko-fi.com/thehakereport. I read them. You can donate overnight, and I read them in the morning on the Hake Report, my morning. But somebody said, Popcorn Stumpcake said that blacks have less margin for error. And I want to comment, black kids versus white kids have less margin for error. They're considered bad kids quicker than white kids are when white kids do similar things, so he says. And a lot of people think and say that. And so I want to give a little credence to that and a little reasoning on why that is. I may touch on this silly story about this German jersey, number 44. It looks like an SS, and I disavow that. But it's just amusing. CNN Style covered it. Cramping my style, CNN Style. I did get a follow-up on the cash for clunkers. You guys had some brilliant calls. Jaime, I believe, in Minnesota called Hake yesterday about cash for clunkers from the 2009-ish thing with Obama. Some of you may not remember. It's before your time. I wasn't really paying attention back then, so I don't really know a lot about it either. But the libertarians and Sean Hannity's and the J.C. Lee Petersons were all over that stuff. And they made some great points about it. And a Big Bump sent me a little article, an op-ed, if you will, from Eric Peters Autos about what it was really all about. Destroying the independence of the young people. So evil. Evil Obama. He did Obamacare, too, to destroy the self-independence of the people. That's what this minimum wage thing is, in my opinion. Some of you guys disagree with me. You're welcome to call in or chat. If I happen to see your chat, I'll try to argue with you in the chat. Argue with your chats, if you're in the live chat. And some other things. Hate cannot be reasoned with. So said a hate-filled black who's bashing this one woman who's on an ego trip, in my opinion, but she's saying some factual things, and it's a mess. Hate cannot be reasoned with. These hate-filled people who hate Trump, hate whites, hate life and nature and nature's God and cause and effect and pattern recognition, stuff like that. They're just hate-filled people. Oh, I want to make the octopus happy. Is pink a bad color? But anyway, guys, let's get right on with the show!
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh. Oh, it's the Hake Report, La La
la. Hey guys! So, how you guys doing? I am fine. I have my get a job, Jesse Lee Peterson, Savage Moments t-shirt on. I don't know who made this graphic. I first saw it on a remix, of a Jesse Lee Peterson remix, that you can find many Jesse Lee Peterson remixes on online. Let me see if I have it on here. Nope, I don't. JesseLeePeterson.com/remixes. You can find some of those remixes there. Not all of them. But, yeah, it's from the Get a Job Teespring store. Let me show you guys. I cracked a little bit. I'm growing. The Get a Job, I posted that in the chat. GetAJob.creator-spring.com is how you can get that. Thanks for the raid, Jake Hudson. Jake Hudson has raided the stream over on Rumble. Nice. You can't get this exact shirt, so get your shirts when you can. It's oftentimes these shirts, Teespring, etc., they're limited edition. They stop being available, whether by the creator's decision or the Teespring themselves. They do stuff, Spring, Creator Spring, whatever you want to call it. Creator-spring.com. So, nice. Shout out to Get a Job. He got summarily banned from YouTube without warning, according to him. And he's not, I have not known him to be a liar at all. And so he's on Rumble. Rumble.com/user/getajob2, I believe is the thing. Yeah, and he uploaded a few parts, 23, 24, and 25, 7 days ago, and he did a part 97, 20 days ago. 97, Jesse Lee Peterson Savage Moments compilations. That's pretty cool. Nice. So I'll post that in the chat, too. Rumble.com/user/getajob2 after that. Number 2? Nice. Okay, so what's up, Facebook crew? Nice to see you, Bethany, everybody over there. So, let me talk about this coffee that I received yesterday. I touched on it yesterday. You know, Popcorn Thump Keg bought me a coffee, saying he saw an IG post the other day where, in which three young white kids were standing at a water fountain pretending like they were, you know, that Calvin from Calvin and Hobbes graphic that you see in the back of people's trucks, these sort of vulgar bumper sticker where he pretends like he's going number one on Chevy or on Ford or on such and such thing. You know, don't do this, kid, but peeing on something on something that he finds distasteful that he doesn't like. Well, they were pretending like they were peeing, but it was really a water fountain, drinking fountain. But they were posing like they were peeing. Anyway, it's kind of like a boyish thing to do. Boys will be boys, you know? Make sure I'm centered. I can't tell if I'm centered because I have my octopus in the way. So a bunch of the comments were, I love it, it's funny, aha, just boys being boys, kids being kids. Glad they're outside not playing video games. We have lower and lower and lower and lower standards for children because society has spoiled and spoiled and spoiled, meaning parents, have spoiled and spoiled and spoiled, and parents have been spoiled for generations by the government and these corporations, commie capitalist corporations. So Popcorn's Thump Keg claimed to have seen similar posts of black kids around the same age doing similar things in public, similar things, but not the same thing. So what does that mean? But the reactions were harsher. Where are their parents? This is so inappropriate, etc. Interesting, huh? So it seems to Popcorn's Thump Keg that black youth often don't get the benefit of the doubt or benefit of just being kids in the way that white kids do. White youth do. Often when they're doing the same things, according to him. I don't know if it's true. Black youth are often told they should know better, when white youth are just being knuckleheads. Just an observation that he's made, or an imagination that he's bought, listened to, or believed, possibly. Thoughts? And I do say that I did mention yesterday that a lot of it is imagination, because it's not the same thing. And I mentioned yesterday that the black kids act out like crazy, much more than the white kids. They have worse parents. And also, it's not just worse parents, it's physically different parents. It's not even whether it's a better or worse thing, because both the parents are evil. Both sets of parents are evil. But white kids and Asian kids, they suppress their children. Make them repressed or suppressed or behave. And that's not necessarily a good thing, although it's beneficial for living a little bit longer of a life without getting putting the smack down on you, the smack put down on you by the powers that be, since you have this fear of authority, you know, that may not be the right kind of respect for authority, right? Of course. But still, it helps you function better in the world. Whites and Asians do that the most. And then blacks and Hispanics are a little bit more defiant. Their authorities are more corrupt. Their parents are the mothers are unfair oftentimes. And so there's no fathers oftentimes, or the fathers are betas. Well, all the fathers are betas all across the board. But it's a mess. Well, also, I will say, when you do more error, as many black kids per capita do, you get less room for error. I mentioned Arnie Duncan, A-R-N-E. I forgot his name yesterday. Arnie Duncan, the education secretary under evil Obama, was like, black and Hispanic kids get punished more because they act out more, but he didn't say that part. So you've already attracted negative attention on yourself, or just attention on yourself. It's like they say, oh, we're over-policed. Not really. Well, yes, some are, but many aren't, because there's also over-violenced, over-crimed, overdoing crime, overly doing crime. So you attract negative attention to the black kids. It becomes a vicious circle, a self-fulfilling prophecy, because they get angry that it's racism when it's not. How many of you guys, press one if you've seen, and I'm going to press one, if you've seen an instance of a black young man crying racism, or a woman, or not even young necessarily, crying racism when they brought some dumb situation, escalated some dumb situation beyond what it should have been. They did it. They created the situation, and then they turn around and cry racism. I'm hitting one. I'm hitting one in the chat. Because I even have an audio recording of it. I was in one spot where this black guy was just escalating with a Hispanic guy who was the authority of that situation. Like, you acting out, go home, you're not going to work today. Crazy, huh? Started a situation, incited a situation that was not even a situation at all. But just because of being stubborn and angry and out of control, and then cried, oh, I'm the only black person in the room, this must be racism. Stupid. And I don't know if it's too, says Beta Legs. Oh, so Beta Legs has not seen that. You're blessed. Every day at 7-Eleven, cries racist to a Hispanic woman, says Jeremy. Yeah, and so whites and others, and we see it in the mainstream media all the time, these blacks in the mainstream media crying racism, and the mainstream media agreeing with them sometimes. And that's why I thought that nobody respected Al Sharpton or Jesse Jackson or stuff like that, people like that. I just thought that they were just put in the mainstream media for some weird reason. just because they're maybe entertaining or something. I didn't know that they were respected or believed, but blacks actually respect and believe people like that. And now there's people even more off the deep end than them. More brazen liars and extremists, if you will. Extreme evil. I don't like that word, extremists, but it is what they are. Vita Man says, you don't get to do foul spoop to black men and then decide how we should react, says Vita Man. What are you talking about? This is what I'm talking about. If Vita Man is a black person who's not just trolling. Because the foul stuff that happened to the blacks was happened by their mothers or by the foul lies that has been brainwashed, imprinted on the brains of the young black kids for generations. Remember that one rapper from a few decades ago? Still not loving police. Wow, no love. Not good. But he claims he still got love for the streets. It's the DRE. He doesn't have love for the streets if he doesn't love the police. Terrible. But out of your imagination and dread, you make the situation what it is. And so, yes, I don't decide how you react. If you're being serious, Vita Man might be trolling me. I'm not deciding how you're reacting. I'm just pointing out that the way you're reacting is what you're bringing on yourself. You reap what you sow, and you're sowing anger and injustice. And some injustice is happening, and some justice is happening. And a lot of the justice that's happening, you're calling it injustice, and it's not injustice, it's justice. But there, of course, is injustice, too. You get both. You get the police looking extra hard, even at the good black kids, if you will. So, yes, in some ways, I'm sure black kids catch a prejudice that other, even like the quote-unquote good ones, that other kids and adults, other black kids and adults have imprinted on the minds of everybody else by their out-of-control behavior. Think about it. You do something wrong and you get caught. You're getting an eye on you. Or a whole bunch of people in your area, your community, do wrong. You get more eyes on you. Well, we're over-policed. But you have more murders per capita in your communities. 4 times as much black-on-black murder per capita than whites. And they're also committing murder at 6 times the rate that whites are committing murder and others. And that is, stop giving them any excuse. Yeah, don't have any excuses. And don't have any bitterness. It's out of control. And just a side note, Popcorn Thumpkeg, based on another one of your super chats, when you were questioning me about my basis for saying the black crime is out of control, do you mean to doubt that black crime is out of control? Because it's really out of control. And so I'm not sure because there's a lot of communist people who will play like it's not. They'll just lie to you. And a lot of intellectuals will be phony and play like they're even-keeled and say, oh no, it's not out of control. It's just the media representation and you guys stereotyping them. But no, it's really out of control. I saw this post on X. I don't know if I have it in the chat. I'm going to put it hipsterhood danger. I'm transferring it into the folder right now, Hassan. Along these lines, shout out to the blacks. Somebody posted on X, Wayne Burkett. Don't harass him. He's actually posting true things. Wayne Burkett, 2 T's at the end. Burkett. There's a whole generation of genre of hipster commentary that can be summarized as, I went to a bad neighborhood and I wasn't immediately executed, so the concerns have clearly been overblown. And he shows a screenshot of somebody on Facebook maybe or Instagram who wrote, today I rode a bike through North County. Don't know which North County this is. I waved at people working in their yards, drivers on the road, and successfully negotiated full lane usage on riding his bike, using the full lane when necessary. The most harrowing incident happened on Arsenal near Tower Grove Park, wherever that is, in North County somewhere, when a driver decided to turn right across the bike lane in front of me. Wow. Don't be afraid of NoCo. NoCo being North County. You see that in the folder there, Hassan? I just dragged it in. Hipsterhood danger. He said, of course, most people in a bad neighborhood are more or less normal, says Wayne Burkett, explaining. Of course, you don't want to be a you won't be a victim of a violent crime there on most days. Correct. The question you should be asking is something like, what is the 10-year victimization rate for a permanent resident? Would the residents get out of there if they could afford it? Type of thing. Or if they didn't really know how to take steps to avoid the danger. I know people who live in hoods. Yeah. Phony people. There was another one that was replying to this guy who said similar things. Just dumb, blind, lame liberals, Reddit bros, who pretend that the crime is not out of control because they can go there and be safe sometimes, most of the time. But you see story after story of some hipster guy getting killed or hurt or robbed or whatever, or gal. People getting punched in the face in New York City by people with mental problems and anger problems, which creates the mental problems. So don't be in denial. I encourage you. Don't be in denial. Have a sense of reality. Okay. All right. Thank you for the super chats, guys. Let me show this German jersey. 44. It's a fake jersey because it's not even... Nobody has 44. This is from CNN Style. It was a viral story because people get caught up in stuff that doesn't matter. This is a situation that doesn't matter. Even Germany. Poor Germany. They got their spirit broken, and maybe not in a good way. After World War II. And World War I, honestly. I hear. CNN Style. Krampen Style. Germany is going to redesign the Adidas soccer jersey numbering amid a Nazi symbol controversy. Article by Omar or Oscar or something. Holland on CNN, Commie Nonsense Network. Posted April 2nd, 2024. And it's a beautiful soccer jersey, football. Football, Globo Homo football. And it has a 44 on it. They posted the picture of it. Wow, CNN, brave, brazen. What are you trying to say, CNN, Commie Nonsense Network? And so what the thing is they're acting like the 44 looks kind of like lightning bolt SS thing. Looks sort of reminiscent of it. And people on the internet were posting that they were... posting this picture. I don't know if anybody actually even bought it. But it's kind of a catchy style, catchy font, cool looking font of these numbers. And you could put names and stuff like that. Deutschland. That's what they call themselves. Germany. Social media users began using Adidas's online customization service to create jerseys bearing... So this is just a preview. It's not even a real picture. See, that's the Deutschland logo. Cool, huh? At least they got to keep some sort of a cool-looking logo. Maybe they'll turn it all girly-looking. German soccer authorities will redesign the number 4 on the country's national jerseys amid claims it resembles a logo used by Nazi paramilitary units 70, 80 years ago, whenever that was, or in 90, I don't know, going on 90 years ago. The German Football Association, DFB, Deutschland Football, blah, 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 something. Shout out to the Germans. I don't know your language very well at all. Ich spreche kein Deutsch. That means I don't speak any German, I think. Maybe. So social media users were doing it. So maybe nobody even bought it. And the SS, and by the way, CNN Style has a typo that I highlighted in this, if you're watching the video. The SS group's lighting-like logo? It's actually lightning-like logo. You know, like a lightning? It's like a zigzag, sort of zigzags, like a Z, but it looks like an S. SS. So they misspelled lightning and they spelled it lighting. Kids, don't make this mistake. The mainstream media has fired a lot of their editors, so they don't have high quality anymore. Because journalism isn't worth anything, so... especially their journalism, which is liberal propaganda, it's not worth anything. It's actually negative worth. It brings evil into the world. But I mean, sometimes they have facts. I mean, I cite CNN all the time, so it has some value. But a lot of their lies, I think it's a net negative on the world. But their job is to be evil, so hey. Their lightning-like logo was designed by German graphic designer Walter Heck. Don't say that word, kids. Who later joined the SS, having previously been a commander in the Nazis' paramilitary wing, the Sturmabteilung SA. Like many Nazi symbols, Heck's logo was based not on ancient runes, as often mythologized by Hitler. This is according to this person on CNN. But a pseudo-rune created by Austrian occultist Guido von List in the early 20th century. Logo was widely used at the time. Some in German typewriters were produced with a stylized SS key. Whoa, dang. They like to ban all the cool-looking stuff. Like... objectively, that thing that they have, you know, the, that thing, or, you know, like the literal lightning strikes. Lightning strikes are just cool. And the, you know, the hooked cross or whatever that thing is, they call it a, what do they call it? Hakenkreuz. the hooked cross. The swastika thing. And then the commies have cool stuff that they get to keep. If you look on your Apple keys, you can find the communist thing. Or, you know, the special characters, you can find the communist, the sickle and hammer thing. It's kind of a cool looking logo, don't quite know what it is. I mean, I know it's a hammer and sickle. So, all the cool stuff... the commies get the cool stuff, but the Nazis don't get the cool stuff. You can't... it's all evil, Hake, says Karen Williams. I know, but it looks cool. And they're also banned my beautiful rebel flag. Evil Amazon did it. Amazon's worse than the beautiful South. So... poor Germany doesn't have freedom. What a mess. In a statement posted to ex-DFB's Deutschland Football something association, had earlier submitted numbers 1 to 26 urines to the European soccer's governing body for review. None of the parties involved saw any proximity to Nazi symbolism, Nazi, I call it, in the creation process of the jersey design. The association said it was taking the matter very seriously in developing an alternative design for the digit of number 4, the numeral 4, the digit 4. Take this dumb stuff so seriously. No, I'm not an undercover Nazi. I barely found out that I had any German in me. But I do have like a little bit of a German in my family tree. Quit whining, Hake, says Frederica. Whatever, man. I want reparations because they took my they took my 44 away. Germany went through a lot. Yeah. These evil people. Mamas. Evil mamas. Okay, let me move on. It's not that important. It's true. It's a good thing not to whine. So, cash for clunkers. Shout out to Big Bump for this. He sent me this tip during the the Hake Report yesterday because I got some calls from people about the cash for clunkers. Jaime in Minnesota called yesterday saying that they were giving, and I don't know if this is a real number. I haven't looked into it. $5,000? Is that true? I want to say that it would be more like $1,500. Bum, 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 bum. Are they still doing it? I thought that there would be a Wikipedia page about it. Car allowance rebate system. Be quiet. Car allowance rebate system. No, no, no. Yeah, car allowance rebate system. CARS. Also known as cash for clunkers, colloquially known as cash for clunkers, a $3 billion, this is from Wikipedia, U.S. federal scrappage program intended to provide economic incentive to U.S. residents to purchase a new, more fuel-efficient vehicle when trading in a less fuel-efficient vehicle. Program promoted as a post-recession stimulus program under Obama, July 1st, 2009, officially started. Claims began July 24th, ended August 24th, 2009, so it lasted like a month. After the appropriated funds were exhausted, having scrapped 677,081 vehicles. Crazy. So, CARS, C-A-R-S, Car Allowance Rebate System. Kind of reminds me of Affordable Care Act instead of Obamacare. So, show this headline, what cash for clunkers, quote-unquote, was really about. It's from this guy named Eric Peters, Libertarian Car Talk website, ericpetersautos.com. Big Bump sent this to me. And according, it's a website subtitled about that it's about automobiles, motorcycles, and libertarian politics. Let me see. Cash for clunch. Did I put it in here? I don't see it in the folder. Hold on. Cash. Oh, no. Let me put it in the folder, Hassan. My bag. ericpetersautos.com. He put out this little op-ed in November of just last year, 2023, saying what cash for clunkers, quote-unquote, Obama era, cash for clunkers was really all about. You may recall, some of you, the Obama era, writes Eric Peters Autos, cash for clunkers business. It's a very dirty business and a key element of Obama's declared intention to fundamentally transform, splitting an infinitive, the United States. Obama talked about, I'm going to fundamentally transform America. We need to fundamentally transform America. I'm not using his voice. We're going to fundamentally transform America. That's not his voice either, exactly. That's Eric Peters Autos. No luck. Is that what that means? A no sign, forbidden sign? Like a crossing out the Ghostbusters no sign? With a three-leaf clover. No three-leaf clover. Eric Peters. Maybe that means no Irish. I don't know. I think it's no luck. Not sure. Very dirty business and key element of Obama's intention to fundamentally transform America, turn it into, change it from a Chris, you can kind of cycle through these images, these screenshots. Turn it in from a Christian nation into a atheist, evil nation. From a family-oriented nation to a LGBT, sex-out-of-wedlock-oriented nation. Killing the babies in the womb-oriented nation. transform America from an independent, personal independence and a national independence to global homo dependent and government dependent nation. And this is what this is. The plan was sold to the public as a means of stimulating, quote unquote, the then flatlined American car industry, which almost literally, and in GM's case, General Motors, actually bankrupt. The idea was to get people to buy new cars by paying them to throw away their old cars, writes Eric Peters in Eric Peters Auto, I think. The cars were not traded in. Here's a picture of Obama back in the day, I guess, standing in front of the American flag. Disgraceful. They were not even parted out, where you go, you take your car to pick apart or some scrapyard where they use the cars for scrap. Major components, such as their engines in particular, were removed in order to be resold to someone in need of low-cost replacement parts. No, no, oh no, they were destroyed. Engines, as High Man Minnesota told me, dosed with silica. He said some type of fluid or something. Silica, like that's the plastic liquid stuff thingy, I guess. And then they ran the engines dosed with silica until they seized. They froze up. They wouldn't turn anymore. Because engines have motors that turn or something like that. I don't know. So as to render them unusable. Evil Obama destroying awesome cars. Sicko. Sicko. Okay. So go to the next one. While on the surface, as in superficially, the Cash for Clunkers program was about getting people to buy new cars, it was fundamentally about getting rid of old, affordable, older cars. Affordable cars. I knew a buddy who spent I was going to text him yesterday. He spent $600, maybe $800 buying a new car, buying a used car off the street. And it was a cool little beater, if you will. The reason for that was to fundamentally transform the country. Split is infinitive. You're supposed to say to transform fundamentally the country, or transform the country fundamentally by breaking evil Obama. Evil Obama, Obama, socialist. Not the good kind of socialist. Some of you guys think some socialism is good, but he was a globo homo. Atheist socialist, not a Christian. by breaking the generations-long tradition. Look at this picture of young people becoming independently mobile, almost adults while they were still in their teens. Look at this picture of these two, they look like little boys from the 80s or 70s. Look, it looks like a girl almost because he has long hair, longish hair. But that's like a teenage boy. Young people used to be independent. They would work. We got this dumb stuff like child labor laws. Makes me spit. I didn't actually spit, but I didn't say two. It's ridiculous. Evil Obama. I'm going to get to a little bit more about him. Look, young people driving, being independent. Responsible. Sometimes responsible. Sometimes not. Driving a death trap mobile in the good old days when we didn't live as long. So we didn't have as much time to do evil in the world. Now we do all kinds of evil. And mama gives us this health care so we stay barely alive. Anyway, the program succeeded wildly, not in terms of stimulating the moribund new car industry, but in terms of making an entire generation indifferent to driving. A measure is, so what he's saying is, he got rid of a whole bunch of cars that could have been sold, like what Jaime said, but I'm a little thick and slow, Hake is, that could have been sold to somebody who could use a relatively cheap car that get from point A to point B, doesn't drive very far, doesn't need it to be all that reliable, you know? Making an entire generation indifferent to driving, writes Eric Peters autos.com, who has somewhat of a vested interest in this issue. A measure of this is the stat that something in the neighborhood of 20%, according to him, I haven't looked up into his numbers, of those who fall in within the age 16 to 24 years old age bracket do not have a driver license. Driver's license. I like to call it driver's license, but it is, and that's unprecedented, according to him. Yeah, yeah. It's ridiculous. Evil Obama. And I remember Sean Hannity would say, because I was driving around working, so I listened to the Jesse Lee Peterson show early mornings, and sometimes I would be driving around, listening to Sean. He would be like, Obama wants, I'm done with this, thank you, Hassan. Obama wants, or these people don't want you having your independence. Because think about it, you have a car, you can go anywhere. You don't have to rely on the public transportation, the government transportation. You don't have to rely on just a little bicycle. Which is, a bicycle is cool too, have both. You don't have to, they can't necessarily keep tabs on you. You can go anywhere. They can't just shut you down. You can, it's independence, it's freedom. Freedom to move about. It's handy. I know people who don't have cars and they're like stranded a lot of the time. Or, you know, they have to go to Uber and say they say something racist against the Muslims. And I disavow that. They get banned from Uber and Lyft. There's this gal who's Jewish, who's like sort of conservative, pro-Trump, who said something, I can't find a non-Muslim driver. And she got banned, you know, because she was trying to Uber around New York City. She got banned from the app. So they got you. They got her by, I don't know what, but they got her. If I had a car, I could go to Hawaii, says Carver 531. Maybe they have ferries to Hawaii. The straight kind of ferries. What's next, Hake, a skateboard? Yeah, I know, the cities crack down on people's skateboards. And they're getting rid of this stuff that's available for cheap. It's like, I think of Trump and versus Obama, and the Trump is like pro-business, making stuff work. Whereas these Obama, Biden, all these evil people with an agenda want to increase like gasoline, coal, electricity. For some weird reason, they don't go for nuclear energy and stuff like that, in order to manipulate you into having desperation to go along with their program and get electric vehicles and all that other stuff in the pretense about the environment, as if they care about that. They just have this mama spirit agenda to control you and make money and all kinds of mess. Globalist socialism, redistribute America's wealth to the so-called poor countries and control and mama spirit. They need to manufacture a crisis so that they can swoop in and save you from that crisis. It's evil. Same thing. That's what the so-called healthcare thing was. You know, Obamacare? Oh, the American healthcare system is in a crisis. Well, partly, I think, is because of the government meddling in it and subsidizing that stuff. When you subsidize something, it gets more expensive. When you subsidize people's lives get more expensive. Minimum wage and all that stuff. So-called health care. Evil Obama. I posted, oh, I don't know if I have this in the screenshot. Obama. Let me see. Oh. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Okay, so screenshot in folder incoming. It's called screenshot. Screenshot. Evil Obama posted Barack Obama on X. Obama, you gotta let the transgender illegals in. Obama, in your early 20s, asks Obama on X, you might not know that the Affordable Care Act is the reason you can stay on your parents' health care plan until you're 26. 26 years old. A grown adult man or woman. Before the ACA, Affordable Care Act, Obamacare, healthcare companies could kick you off earlier, sometimes right after college, which would be like 22, 23 if you graduate on time. It's another reason, which they should kick you off right away. You shouldn't be depending on your parents. But no, they make it so that you have to be, and then it's to push you towards dependence on the government or their rules so they can control you. It's another reason why we need to keep on building on the ACA, not repeal it, because healthcare isn't a privilege, it's a right. No, it's not. Healthcare is not a right. That's a lie. That's a communist, socialist, mama spirit lie. And look how they lightened him up, by the way. He's actually, I'm pretty sure, darker than that. On his own account. This is his ex account. On Elon Musk's ex, Twitter. We're looking at a screenshot of him. He sort of looks... Never mind, I'm not going to bring that up. I was going to say he sort of looks like my dad. Only half black and full and 100% evil. No, is there any half decency in him? I don't know. And if you have a pre-existing condition, yeah, they got rid of the healthcare companies, health insurance companies, so-called health medical service insurance companies can't reject you for having pre-existing conditions. Can't not cover your pre-existing conditions. You got all kinds of mess. You lived a messy life, or you were born with a messy situation. They can't be like, oh, we can't cover that. So that's going to put them out of business eventually, because they have so many people not taking care of themselves, and immigrants and illegals and sickly, unhealthy people having the S out of wedlock and doing the LGBT thing. Some of that's not good for you, for your life. And it's going to put private companies out of business if they just have to endlessly have to support you endlessly. Because some people's costs go way, like, through the roof. Maybe there can be some who are specializing in that stuff to help you out. But every company has to have to have every so-called health insurance company has to do that? No. It's not a privilege, it's a right. No. If it were a right, you would be able to do it yourself without anybody stopping you. That's what a right is. Something that you can do and nobody can stop you. Like, I can speak my mind and nobody can stop me. Although I don't really have that. It's not a right. It's a need. You can call it a need, but it's not a right. It's communism. Hake hurting my feelings now, says Terry. What? What am I doing? Okay. So I told you guys, I've brought this up before. Basically, my point in bringing this up is 26 years old. They're trying to keep young people more and more and more immature, older and older and older and older. Obama's still immature. Hake, look at Hake. He's still immature. It's bad. It's bad. And these mamas are enabling it, which is evil. That's my only point. David in Ocala, Florida is on the line. David, thank you for calling and holding there, man. What's up? How you doing?
Hey, I thought I'd call in since I sold cars during that cash for clunkers stuff.
Okay, let's hear it.
Yeah. Well, it was only for new cars, okay? You got to remember that. So
what's that mean?
Well, you could only get the discount if you bought a new car. You couldn't get it if you bought a pre-owned, like even an 1-year-old car. It didn't qualify.
Oh, so you take your slightly older car in, and you have to buy a new car, otherwise you don't get that money.
Right. Well, I had they were mainly like really like 15 to 20 year old cars.
What let me interrupt you briefly. Pardon me.
Sure. That's okay.
What a phony, artificial, overly complicated addressing symptoms thing to do rather than just do what's right. Go back to basics. Get rid of minimum wage, like I always say. Get rid of just enforce the laws and get the government out of helping and stuff like that. Encourage people to leave people to their own devices so they have to be responsible or drown, you know, sink or swim. Rather than that, they have to do this way complicated thing subject to corruption and mess. Anyway, go ahead. I interrupted you.
Well, it did help stimulate the new car, you know, industry somewhat. Okay, but
that's
what
not
it
a
did,
good thing.
Well, it was if you were in the car business anyway.
But that's not good overall. Like, you get ill-gotten gain. You get, like, the illegals who come in here. It's not good for the illegals to come in here.
No, it's not.
It may seem good to them because they're living the easy life in America now. They're safer and all that stuff. But it's not good that they do that. It's not good for them to be coming here illegally and being dishonest, you know?
Right.
So
right.
It's I get that stuff like Obamacare, somebody used Obamacare to save their life. Well, that's nice. It saved their life, but there's more than one way to save a life. And it doesn't have to be by evil mama spirit Obamacare, you know? There's more than one way to save the car industry, or you could let it die and then the new ones buy it, deregulate it to an extent, and new ones come up. So anyway, go ahead.
I was going to say this. Listen, first off, the car industry, if the car industry goes down, the whole country goes down. And I'm surprised that COVID, you know, if COVID would have lasted longer because of that chip issue, we definitely would have went into the Great, Great Depression because, you know, like I told you a long time ago, I saw car dealerships that were doing 240 a month go all the way down to doing 100, 110 cars a month, okay? That's just one dealership.
So in half, it went into like less than half.
Right. So then you go.
And this is back in 2009? This is back in 2008, 2009?
No, when COVID hit.
Oh, China virus.
So it almost, with the car industry going down back then, it almost, you know, took it out. But anyway, the problem with what they did with the cash for clunkers is by taking out all those cars, those inexpensive cars, at that particular time, the average new car was $25,000. The average new car right now is $60,000.
Wow.
And when COVID was in, this is like I've been on the news, the manufacturers concentrated on $55,000 cars, okay? $40,000 to $70,000 cars because they made more profit off of them.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And so it's a control thing. It's a control thing, you know.
Yeah, it's manipulative. And Frederick in the chat says, "Hake, it's not a perfect world." That's why I say you get rid of this stuff, because people are evil. People are corrupt, and these things are subject to corruption. These are not solutions. They're temporary band-aids and little welfare stuff. And welfare stuff doesn't solve the root issue. You solve the root issue by get rid of these corrupt incentives.
Well, that's what I'm going to go into next.
Okay.
You know, the control thing is do you not think that because now see remember all those old cars, they didn't have computer chips in them. Okay. So if they dropped this so-called EMPs or whatever like that, those cars would still go. But, man, those cars are almost all gone unless you got an old Mustang or Camaro or an old Ford truck or something like that.
You're talking about EMP bombs, those things.
A nuclear
bomb that's set off in the sky and it destroys all of our electronic equipment.
Right. All the cars are gone because they're computer controlled.
And so that wouldn't affect the old school, really old cars?
Nope.
Are you sure? Because those things have electricity.
Yeah, but they didn't have those computer chips, man.
Oh, the chips get destroyed? That's what gets destroyed?
Yeah, there's so many onboard computers on these cars nowadays. That's why they're so expensive, because people want all this crap like the truck drives itself. We are spoiled. This country, it's ridiculous. When these customers come in, this new generation, they're sick, man. I mean, they want all this stuff. I mean, anyway,
with control, not just EMP bombs, like they can hack them and control you or shut you down.
Well, that's what I'm about. Yeah, get to. You don't think they can turn these cars off? And I'm going to show you something right here. Remember, you'll remember this because it happened in California. Remember when Anne Hesh and her Prius ran into that house and it caught her car on fire, okay, at over 100 miles an hour?
Uh-huh.
And they pulled her out of the burning house, put her on a stretcher to put her into the ambulance, and she broke out of that. Like, they had some kind of, like, sheet over her because they knew she was burned.
Yeah.
Well, supposedly she had, you know, and you can disavow this if you want, supposedly she was on track to bust in a sex trafficking ring, and she just went and got a wig from this person and said, people are following me, so that's why I'm buying this wig from you. And if you don't think that they could tap into her car, you're crazy. The technology that they have in the government, if people knew the truth, it'd scare them to death.
Well, yeah, I mean, I don't know the conspiracy stuff, but there's something wise about that there's something I respect about these old timers who maintain their privacy and their control and paying with cash and not putting so much on the internet. Even though I do fall for some of that convenience stuff, it's like kind of fun. But
well, that's why they want these electric cars, man. You don't think they can shut them jokers off at a dime, okay? And the global warming thing is just, you know, listen, if China and India is the major issue, deal with them. The global warming and the climate change thing that's being pushed
China is another
control mechanism.
Yeah,
they want
they're
to
doing
control you.
They're the biggest offender is not us, I hear.
Right. But they're not doing anything about it. And they parade that young girl from Europe, whatever her name is, you know,
Greta Thunberg. Greta Thunberg, my fellow autistic, because people say that I'm autistic. I don't know. I was born before autism came out.
Why did they say you have autism, by the way?
Because I focus too much on unimportant things. I over-explain stuff.
I think I have a little bit of autism because I... Because of numbers, man, I can remember numbers. I can remember stuff. I mean, I remember stuff all the way back to when I was 2 years old and freaked people out. So I got to be on some kind of spectrum like that. You know?
Everybody has, you know, little issues. I mean, I get that there are extreme cases and it's a mess and it's increased for some odd reason. And I won't speculate right now. Why?
Probably those when they take your kids in, try to put them into school and what they do to them, you know, with
there's
the
all kinds of mess.
Yeah. Hey, let me ask you something. When was the last time you bought a car and went out shopping?
It was 2011. February 2011 is when I bought my used. I bought it used too. I wanted a stick shift because I wanted to learn stick.
Cool.
I wanted to be a man. And so he taught me stick shift and I bought it.
What kind of car is it?
It's a Corolla S. Oh, nice.
Yeah, man. I used to sell them.
Nice, man.
Go ahead. I used to sell them, and with that manual transmission, they got a lot more low-end power to get you out, you know, off the line and everything like
that.
Yeah,
it has some oomph, even though it's a four-cylinder.
right. That's a great car, man. You could put 250,000 miles on that car if you just change the oil, right?
I'm not far from that. That's cool, man.
You're not?
Well, yeah, I have probably 60,000-70,000 more to go before I hit 250,000. But it already had like 60,000 or 70,000 on it when I bought it. So.
Oh wow.
Yeah, it's a lot for just two, three years.
Well, they're so rare. They made about one out of every 50 of them cars was that car. That was the price leader car to get people to come in and buy the other cars.
Nice. Mm-hmm. Cool, man.
Anyway, I just wanted to comment on that because. You know, it's just like when they gave out the money for the pandemic, you know, that created inflation.
Yeah.
And the same thing basically happened when they did the cash for clunkers thing and took out all those low-priced cars that made all the other cars go up now, which you can see now. It took a little bit of time, but go out and try to buy a used car right now or any car, and you're going to pay top dollar for it.
Right. Yep. It's crazy, man. It's a mess.
Yeah. All right. Oh, let me hold on. I just want to say. Oh, I just wanted to comment one thing real quick about these people that are controlling everything and shit. You know, I thought about this the other day. You know, Ivana Trump, you know, was probably the most beautiful second lady that they're, you know.
You mean Melania, first
Melania,
lady.
Melania, that's what I meant, Melania.
And
I'm
she was
sorry.
First yeah. lady.
First lady, yeah, see what I'm talking about?
Yeah, yeah.
You know, there's these stuff like that. My friends just bust out laughing. Anyway, the way she dressed up the White House, you know.
Oh, she beautiful. Decorated it, you mean?
Yeah, she did. It was gorgeous, okay? And then the news media, you know, just pounded on that lady, you know, just crucified her, basically. And then Biden gets in, and they trick it out like some kind of Candyland thing with a homosexual freaking elf running around the joint. So
really?
Who's messed up, man? Who is messed up? You tell me. You know what I'm saying? They're disturbed.
Yeah, okay? True.
And it's only getting worse. My prediction is to y'all, you young people out there, because remember, I'm 58 years old. This country can't make it another 20 years like this. It's not going to happen. There's either going to be a major revolt, okay? Some
yeah.
type of, you know, who's going to keep putting up with this? You know what I'm saying?
Oh, people will get used to it. You'd be surprised what people acclimate to. Look at, well, I've never seen North Korea, but look at just how stuff has changed and what people have accepted just in your lifetime that would have been unthinkable at the beginning of your life, you know?
That's true. That's
shout out
like
to the older generations who know different, know better in
yeah,
some ways.
Yeah, that's right, man. That's right. That's why you should. That's why people need to listen to this show and listen to people like you, because that is exactly right. But see, I'm not putting up with it. Anyway, hey, take care, man. Thanks for having me on to talk about them cars. Okay.
Right on, David. Appreciate you.
All right, take care. All right, y'all. Bye.
Bye. Man, we're past the top of the hour. Let me take one or two more calls, though, guys. Because it's my show, I do what I want, maybe. Ken, a first-time caller in Florida, is on the line. What's up, Ken? How you doing?
Hey, James. How are you?
I'm doing fine. How are you? It's good to hear from you.
All is, as Jesse would say, all is well.
Right on.
I just wanted to say, I think you're great. I love your show, and you're fantastic on Jesse Lee Peterson's show as well.
Thank you.
I wanted to comment on the Obamacare thing. I totally agree with you, because I remember when they introduced that, everybody was all excited at work because there were people that were working there full time. They were going to get benefits. As soon as that came, they found that loophole and they cut everyone's hours so that because I think you would be entitled if you worked 32 hours or more to get the benefits.
Uh-huh.
They cut people down to like 30 hours, 28 hours not to get
so
it.
So they wouldn't have to cover you. I mean, they wouldn't
exactly.
have to cover your so-called health insurance. So you and many of us would rather work those extra hours, and we don't care about so-called health insurance. But the company can't do that because they can't afford to do it. So they have to, the government is, pardon my language, kids, but screwing them over. And you're getting messed up. Sorry. I don't know how else to express it. I don't have a big vocabulary right now.
Yeah, they're evil.
Yeah.
And also, I wanted to comment on the minimum wage. I knew that was a bad thing because I've been a retail manager, and as soon as the wages go up, you can't give people the amount of hours that they were working before. You can't
yeah.
hire enough people. So, I mean, the people that, although your wage increased, your hours decreased, so you're making less than you were doing before. And so it's like Jesse says, children of the lie.
Yeah.
It's a total BS game.
I know. And then there are liars who say, experts say it doesn't result in a loss of jobs. I heard.
That's because they're not doing those jobs. They're elitist.
Right.
They live in a bubble.
Yeah.
They live in a bubble. I wanted to ask you, are you and anybody on the team, are you guys on Truth Social by any chance?
I personally am. I don't use it a lot, but I have the Hake Report is on Truth Social. I'm the only one I
okay.
know around here.
Okay, I'll look for that because I just joined up, and I've been giving shout outs about Jesse Lee Peterson, like to Donald Trump, and
that's cool.
Like a lot of different people. I'm sure the Great White Hope knows of Jesse Lee, but
right on.
I just, you know, I'm trying to push Bond on my end.
That's cool, man. Appreciate that. Ken in Florida.
Yeah. Yes, and I just want, again, doing a great job. Keep it up.
Thank you, man. Call again sometime.
All right. Yes, sir. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye. And I got to get to William in California on the line here. William, thank you for calling, man. What's up?
All right. How you doing?
Doing fine.
Yeah, didn't I tell you about that Obamacare and the connection with the job? I think it's 37 hours they put them in. Remember, they were celebrating when Obama came in office. We got a job. They had these Walmart jobs and you know.
Shout out to Walmart.
I mean, it was a game, just like the cars. Yes, it is true. David Ocala. Shout out to David Ocala. I like David Ocala.
Oh, yeah.
He is absolutely right about the cars. They are, I mean, I can't even open the hood of my car.
Oh, really?
You can't do nothing to the cars, man.
Yeah.
And they do have these components that are capable of shutting a grid down. And we are depending on China, which I hope we get out of, for the chips. And it is
the computer chips,
the older cars. Yeah, the older cars cannot be shut down with that situation if it was World War III.
Wow.
But very, very true. You won't see an aircraft carrier named after Barack. And he did a serious disservice to the country.
Yeah, true, man.
And I see you on the case of the blacks, the women.
Oh, yes.
You keep them. I tell you, go on a date one.
Nice.
And while you at it, I was listening to something, and I don't want to dox other people's shows, but there was a proud, fabulous black woman, and the guy asked her, if you're so fabulous, let me ask you, do you have any sons? And I never thought of this, but the guy said, do you have any sons? And she said, yes. And he said, is he married? And she said, yes, and they have a kid. And he says, is she a splitting image of you or the same nationality? And the woman said that the girl that's married to her son is total opposite of her. And he said, well, normal cases, men like women that remind them of their mother.
Yeah.
And maybe you might want to take a look at why you're so abrasive.
No, I'm not taking any of it personally. It's continue.
Look, women, especially black women, have messed up these kids. And they're staying home until they're 26 now. And that's another thing about Obamacare.
Yep.
You're going to stay home with a NASCAR blanket on your bed, playing PlayStation, and on Obamacare at mama's house. That's why Jesse says mama. That's why Trump says go home to mommy.
Right.
He knows what he's talking about.
Yep. True.
Yeah. So you're going to do some country western music?
You know what? Not me. I have, what music do I have? Oh, I have some old 80s Christian music to play. It'll be kind of nice. I think you might enjoy it to an extent.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. You know, I give you a chance. You know that.
Cool.
And shout out to Rick and Virginia out there. You know, keep that up. Keep spreading that good information because these younger men, they actually need that, and they've been deprived of men and their families because 90% of the women in the black community divorce their husbands if they do get married.
Yeah.
And a lot of the kids end up with no father. And the best person, I'm going to tell you, the best and most important person in the household to a child is the father. It's not the woman.
Okay. Yeah, I agree with that. Yep.
If you don't
believe
me, just look at the results. That's all you have to do.
Yeah. That's a fact, Jack. Thank you, man. Appreciate you, William.
I mean, just look at it. I mean, look at their neighborhoods. They got smoke shops, liquor stores, speed bumps, garbage cans not put up every week, and mothers at home with test tube babies. They're just really bad kids. They are. And it's not that they're being picked on and everything. Your areas are more policed because you don't cut your grass, you don't have no pride in your property and your communities, and that's why you get over-policed. And it's not because you're black.
Right. That's why, and that lack of, that understanding of their lack of understanding is what I think helps you be patient with them.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Yeah, because they need right. they need somebody to be not impatient with them and just roll.
Just tell them the truth.
Yeah, yep.
And be direct with them. Don't yeah, but people so much. Don't say so much of the. See, you're talking about black women on the air, brother, and I'm telling you, you're getting ready to get the yeah, what abouts.
I know. True.
You're getting ready to get attacked with the yeah, what about?
Yeah. The whites do it too.
Whites do it too. Yeah, ridiculous. But that takes you completely off the focus of what you're talking about. They can't stay right on focus. They want to move the goalposts 7 times before they answer one simple question.
Yeah.
What about the blacks?
True.
You
nice,
will not
William.
Get a straight answer. You hear what I said? You will not get a straight answer.
Yeah. It's true. People are insane.
Time for some music, ladies and gentlemen.
Nice. Right on, man.
Take care.
You too. I will get back to your calls and super chats, guys. But let's enjoy Steve Taylor Tuesday. Well, I say let's. I'm going to enjoy Steve Taylor Tuesday. I don't know about you. You guys may go bye-bye and forget to come back to Hake. Don't go away. Hake will be right back. This is a Hero from the 1984 album Meltdown from Steve Taylor. I hope you enjoy it, you musical Philistines. I'll be right back for the rest of hour two. Hang tight.
When the house fell asleep, there was always a light, and it fell from the page to the eyes of an American boy. In a storybook land, like a dream what I read, when it went to my head, I'd say, I wanna be a hero. But the practical side said the question was still, when you grow up, what will you be? I wanna be a hero. I wanna be a hero.
Want to be a hero?
I want to be a hero.
Shout out to Steve Taylor.
And it spoke to my heart from the moment I prayed. Here's a pattern I made for you. I want to be a hero. be a hero. I wanna be your hero.
Well, thank you guys for bearing with me through that kind of nice music, right? I got super chats to read before I get back to calls and stories. Over on buymeacoffee.com, CSAL bought 5 coffees. Hey, CSAL, nice to see you super chatting. Hakey poo! The Mexicans have much less margin for error. That chancla has no patience. Oh, meaning the mothers pull off their chancla and smack you with it? Wow. Crying laughing face emoji, and then crying, full-blown crying, not laughing emoji. Thank you, CSAL, with your 5 coffees. Very generous. Thanks for all you do, Hake, she says. Now a member. Hey, a monthly supporter. You can become a member on Buy Me a Coffee. Cool, huh? Sweet. Gracias. Much grass. CSAL. By the way, you can catch Joel Friday TV live right after Hake. He's going to be talking about, what did I just said it to redirect to you guys. Can You Lie with Love? Joel Friday TV. Monday through Thursday, 11 a.m. Pacific time. Let me double check. The Mac Daddy Allen bought a coffee. Hello, Mr. Hake. How do I find out how to make boys first with 7 coffees? He asks that question. You find out by, you kind of have to ask in person, to, JLP. Maybe he'll let you know. Because, we can't say over the internet. It's very secret information. And I'm not even sure I know. I guess time will tell, maybe. That Mac Daddy Allen bought 3 more coffees. Wowee, I have a driver's license. Obamna. Nice, right on. The Mac Daddy Allen, appreciate that. That's cool. I received several super chats over on Rumble, some Rumble rants. I mentioned Jake Hudson raided the stream. Thank you, man. Nightwave Radio, ayo. He says, "What's up, dude?" Thanks, man. Thanks for the Rumble rant support. That's cool. Nice to hear from you, Nightwave Radio. I like his show. It's a vibe. Mersh was on The Fallen State with Jesse Lee Peterson alongside his co-host of Revenge of the Sis, that one Hispanic guy, blanking on his name, but also a great guy, so check that out. Let me see, Revenge of the Sis, The Fallen State, boom, 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 Royce and Mersh, Royce is the guy, and Mersh from Revenge of the Sis joined Jesse Lee Peterson, and let me see if I, anyway. So you can find that on The Fallen State. Let me just do TFS. TheFallenState.tv. It's also on Rumble. Rumble.com/TFS. Did you know? Let me see. Rumbles. See if that worked. Nope. Rumble 3? Nope. Rumble. That doesn't help. Whatever. Nice. Thank you, Nightwave Radio. Prep Ham Paul says Japan has a shrine symbol. This is a Rumble rant too. Japan has a shrine symbol that is a reverse image of the swastika. It's a positive symbol of Buddhism. Google it. What, you mean that totally useless website, Prep Ham Paul? Yeah, that's what I heard. When I was in high school, somebody said the Hindus in India, which Japan, I don't know, somewhat... It's Asian. It means peace or something like that. Let me type in rumble.com/TFS. That's the Fallen State Rumble channel, which JLP's Jesse Lee Peterson Rumble channel has the live stream of the episodes on Fridays, the premieres. It's not a live stream, but it's a live stream of the premiere, pre-recorded. And so you can check that out. But The Fallen State does have a Rumble, its own Rumble channel. So does Bond, Rebuilding the Man. Thank you for the info, Prep Ham Paul. I may look that up sometime. That's cool. Jen Mull says, great show and great callers. Common sense without motive is refreshing and rare these days. TY, which is short for thank you. That's cool. Thank you for the support there. Did you know you can super chat Hake on Rumble as well? Sweet. I'm all clear on Streamlabs and Ko-fi, K-O-F-I. And on DLive, shout out to 555555565 for the lemons. Thank you for the support, as always, fellas, redheaded stepchildren. Speaking of great callers, Jaime in Minnesota is back on the line today. What's up, Jaime? Thanks for calling and holding there. Are you there?
Hey.
Hey,
I was thinking about the cars that they have today. One second.
Yeah.
And I was looking up, doing a little research, and they got this Ford Explorer, $50,000, a 2020, so it's used. But you see, the engine that it has in it is a four-cylinder.
Oh, wow.
And it's a turbocharged four-cylinder.
Yeah.
And it'll get you 300 horsepower.
Wow.
Which is... That's impressive.
It is.
But you see, when you get that much performance out of a vehicle, the parts inside, they deteriorate. And
okay.
It doesn't matter, you know, how much oil changes you do and how good you take care of it.
Yeah.
A little tiny engine like that, it won't last. Like
a V6 or a V8 is a bigger engine and will last longer. Because it's less stressed?
Right. There's more. Yeah. So I have a V8 Dodge Charger.
Okay. Wow.
5.7 liter, huh?
My goodness.
It's a 2009.
5.7 liter. I have no clue what that means, but it's...
don't worry. Just be impressed.
Yeah. Nice. Awesome.
It's got 350 horsepower, okay?
Yeah.
Now, this four-cylinder is putting out close to what that V8's putting out. That V8 will last a lot longer because it can spread out the heat and such things.
Makes sense. That makes sense.
Now this is a Ford Explorer. It's a big, it's a big vehicle.
Right. I'm surprised to hear that trucks and SUVs have four-cylinder cars sometimes. I'm like, I just kind of assume that anything bigger than a Corolla or a Civic have six cylinders at least, but they don't.
It's not just sometimes anymore.
Wow, it's
that
most of the time?
That is what it is. Like, I saw a 2025 Ford Explorer. They're going to put four cylinders in them.
Is that because with fewer cylinders, is it less gas guzzling?
Right. The smaller the engine. Like, I had a Geo Metro one time, had three cylinders.
You oh, my
like
goodness.
30, 40 miles to the gallon in that thing.
Yeah.
But you ain't going very far, or you ain't going very fast.
Yeah.
And you don't get the acceleration, and you better not be carrying anything.
Right.
But when you turbocharge a vehicle, you're adding a lot of air, which is good. You get a lot of power, but you also increase the heat really fast.
Okay.
And you decrease the amount of fuel that's needed. So you use a lot less fuel.
Yeah.
You use a lot more air, but you also... heat up the engine.
Yep.
A lot higher.
You know, you can tell me if this is not related or it is related. I drove a little Saturn when I was right out of high school or, college or something at some point. And the heat was at like a quarter. So I don't know how hot that is, but the gauge was at like a quarter all the time. But when I got the Corolla in 09, the little Saturn was like a late 90s, mid 90s. And so this Corolla, the heat gauge is at half of the full rather than a quarter of the full. And of course, these are not temperatures. These are not actual temperatures. So I may be just being dumb and this is not related. But could that be related? Like the newer cars run hotter? And they don't, without overheating?
That's interesting. I don't know. I haven't. The newest car I've ever driven is a 2014.
Okay.
And that's a diesel. But you see, with the pistons, okay, with a gas powered engine, the pistons are they're not as strong as like with a diesel. They're really strong. They're really thick and heavy.
Diesel pistons are thicker and heavier.
Right, and diesel engines, they have turbochargers.
Right.
That are a lot stronger because they use pressure to make the explosion.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas gas vehicles, they use a spark to make the explosion mostly. It's a spark. And now they don't put heavy duty pistons in gas engines.
Yeah.
Even if they're turbo, they might be a little bit better, but the piston's going to fail sooner or later, the piston ring, and then you got to get a new engine. Now, these engines, that V8 that I have, it's not turbocharged, just a regular engine. I can take that apart, you know, put a new head gasket on it, take the camshaft out. But one of those vehicles, I can't. There's no way. I got a job, you know, so I'd have to pay somebody to do that. And that's going to cost a lot of money.
I don't know anything about car stuff, but my old boss at my old job talked about how a lot of these turbocharged diesel engines are in normal cars in like Europe and elsewhere. They're getting like even back then, this was like the early mid 2000s, they got 40 miles to the gallon diesel. Yeah. And I'm like, how come they don't do that in America? Why don't they do clean diesel in America?
Well, yeah, I got a VW diesel car.
Okay. Wow.
A little car.
Uh-huh.
And that does a really good job. I like it.
What's wrong with it? What's up with America that we don't have that widespread in America? Do you know?
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
You get the diesel trucks.
Right. But
if you're
normal cars,
diesel, you normal, want a truck.
Normal cars got really nice mileage off of diesel. 40 yeah. miles to the gallon for a little for a nice Jetta or nice, well, you may differ with it, whether that's nice or not, but a nice VW or a Jetta or whatever. That's a lot of mileage, especially back then. I thought.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Anyways, the point of that is, so they did the cash for clunkers, you know,
yeah.
give us your old vehicles. Now they're souping these cars up to the point where, like a normal guy, like me or you, we can't do anything with it. And once it's busted, if we don't have the cash to, you know, to pay a mechanic to...
Yeah.
replace the engine,
mm-hmm.
and we got a $50,000-$60,000 paperweight.
Terrible.
And this is good for like the rich people, you know, the people that they got a lot of money, they took care of their finances really good, and
yeah.
that's fine for them. But you know,
and it's good for those companies because they get guaranteed business. These companies that fix cars or make cars or whatever.
Well, sure, but a car like a 2009 that doesn't have all this souped-up stuff in it, I can get that fixed, you know,
right.
at least for, you know, a much cheaper price than one of these brand-new 2025s that, you know, it'll, yeah, so.
All this computer stuff and all that? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, they're going to screw a lot of people over.
Yeah. Terrible.
And I don't know about the EMP thing. That's, you know, I usually live for... like I'm going to be okay for the next, you know, 50 years or whatever. I don't think about end of day
EMP bombs and stuff like that. yeah.
I don't plan for that kind of stuff because if that happened, then there's a lot bigger problems than my
True.
Car running.
Good point. Nice.
Yeah. Oh, that Brave browser.
Uh-huh.
You use that, right?
I do use a Brave browser.
I use it too. It's pretty good. I get cryptocurrency from it, from looking at the ads.
Oh, really? Nice.
So I got a nice little stack going.
Oh, right on. I probably could I should be using stuff like that. I think I have this. Is that what this thing is? What is this thing? Start your web Tron link or something like that. Somebody got me on it. I would be using the Safari or some dumb thing like that, or in Chrome. I use Chrome and Safari and Firefox and Brave browser. I respect because Brave browser was started by the guy who made JavaScript, who was in Mozilla. He was like the CEO or something of Mozilla, you know, Firefox. And then the evil, liberal, lame Firefox people, employees, ousted him because he supported Prop 8, California Prop 8, marriages between one man and one woman, because he's a Christian. He doesn't believe in the so-called same-sex marriage stuff. So the guy who, Brendan Eich, is that what his name was? I forget what his name was. But years ago, when I was producer of the J.C. Lee Peterson show, they got rid of him, and so he went and created Brave instead of Firefox. Firefox is liberal. Brave is normal. Brave is probably not kind of liberal, too. Who knows? But
sure.
Crazy.
But I guess the lesson from the cash for clunkers and the new vehicles that they're putting out is hold on to your old vehicles if you got them.
Nice.
Don't let go of them no matter what they offer you, because in the end, that car, you know, a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush.
Yeah, I totally agree with that. I have my vehicle that's, I've had to spend a lot of money fixing it, and it's for one, I like it, but for two, it's worth something to me, and getting a new car or getting a new used car, whatever, I won't be able to get enough money out of my car that I have to pay for the car that a newer car that I would want. So hold on to my car that I like. It's fine, you know? So.
Yeah. And two of the biggest debts that people have are student loans and car loan, the car note.
Oh.
You get them every time.
Wow. So and then some people have house loans too, but yeah.
And if you want to build wealth, you can't be paying it out to loans.
Yeah, you don't want to be in debt. Especially not for stuff that's losing in value, like a car or a so-called education.
Yeah, and education and IED. You don't need that.
IED? In improvised explosive device?
No, what's that? EDI?
Oh, DEI. Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion. Yeah, true. Yep.
Yeah.
Great call, man. Appreciate you. Jaime in Minnesota. Take care. Interesting guy. I like him. Okay. Hate cannot be reasoned with. Only have like 20 minutes to go until I have to play some music and switch over to Joel Friday TV. So let me do what I can here. Hate cannot be reasoned with. Posted these. I have some screenshots of this. Guardian tweeted this out. The far-left extremist foreign outlet, The Guardian, which does not represent the interests of our brothers, our English brothers, British brothers. Shout out to the UK people. It's a Guardian is out of the UK. Hate cannot be reasoned with. So why is black radio, and they capitalize the B in the word black because they're kiss-ups. Let me see. Hate cannot be reasoned with. It's a black anti-Candace thing folder there, Hassan. Oh, I have too many screenshots here. So why is black radio hosting quote-unquote conversations with this woman, Candace Owens? And it has a picture of this woman who's been in the mainstream media. With her hair all fancy. Is that her hair? The Guardian opinion. It's an opinion article. And the subtitle reads, when you go to the headline, the darling of the far right. Yeah, right. See, that's like too much makeup, my opinion. It doesn't look natural to me. But anyway, the darling of the far right, give me a break, recently appeared on The Breakfast Club. That's a black radio station out of, what is that, Chicago or New York? I forget. And Joe Budden's podcast. I guess these are my competitors. I never heard of Joe. I've heard the name Joe Budden, but I'm not familiar. Exploiting black America's willingness to forgive. What a lie. This is an article by Michael Harriott, H-A-R-R-I-O-T, who I guess must be black, but might not be black. And they write, this woman who's been in the media, she got herself fired from Daily Wire, right, I guess? Usually presents her anti-black, capital B, black views. And I don't listen to her much, so I don't know what she says. But I don't think that she says anti-black stuff. But maybe she does, I don't know. Maybe she is a hateful person. She didn't marry a black. But a lot of so-called pro-black people who also hate blacks marry white, so it doesn't mean anything. It just means that you're messed up. Views from the safe space, get it? Usually safe spaces are liberal. Nah. Of right-wing outlets. Right-wing outlets. So, let's see. What's interesting to me is hate. Them saying hate cannot be reasoned with. And this is a hateful person saying that. Because you're a liberal, you're a hateful person. You believe in... You follow emotions and all that. And I gather that this is a liberal, maybe even a black. A black who's into the blackness, right? And they write, this Michael Harriott person from The Guardian. Propped up black writer in The Guardian, I guess, maybe. Owens, this woman, they're not supposed to use the last name for a female. When a woman is in the public eye, you're supposed to use her first name, not her last name. Because her last name makes her able to be confused with her husband. Although she didn't take her husband's name. So, it's confusing. But when you say Obama, referring to Michelle, no, you call her Michelle. And then Obama is Barack Obama. So, learn how to do things. At least that's how the old way used to be. Which is more sensible, in my view, at least in this case, than this. Candace Owens, this woman, has no legitimate expertise in politics, media, sociology, or public policy. She's just a person who says things. Nice. So there's nothing wrong with that, to me. No legitimate expertise in politics, media, sociology, or public policy. This person believes in experts, I guess. Or pretends to when it's somebody with whom he disagrees. Black America's willingness to forgive. what else did I have in this? Blacks don't forgive. That's their problem, is they don't forgive. And this person talks out of both sides of his mouth. Unlike many people, I do not believe Candace Owens' politics cancel out her blackness. Even though you think she's anti-black. And I think that she's somewhat conservative. She used to be liberal. Owens is part of the black community and all black stories are valid, says this person. Besides, you're talking out of both sides of your mouth, which is to say you are contradicting yourself because just earlier you called her anti-black and she has no expertise. She's a person who says things, which most blacks are. And most of us are. This is America. This guy may or may not be a foreigner or an American. Many African Americans subscribe to conservative principles. Everyone knows a black Republican. You can usually tell by the quality of their edge up. That must be a black term. This person is black confirmed. No, I don't know. When researching my recent book, Black AF History, America First? Is that what AF stands for? Or is it a vulgar... As blank F word, blank, the unwhitewashed story of America. I wanted to use contemporaneous firsthand experiences of black people in America. Free and enslaved, liberal and conservative, blah, 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 blah. So this person wrote a black book. I think he is black. Michael Harriet. I found it amusing that this person thinks blacks are forgiving. And that's a common lie that they say about themselves. We're so forgiving. No, you're not. You would not be projecting other people as haters when you're the hater. Now, there are a whole lot of so-called conservatives who are hate-filled. Maybe this one might be a hate-filled person. Certainly doesn't stay home and... She's a mother. Should be a mother. But this person, hate-filled person, let me prove to you this is a hate-filled person. Other previous articles. White solidarity doesn't last much longer than the flowers left at memorials to black lives. This is a person who hates white allies who support so-called Black Lives Matter. And then they move on. Because people move on. Because life goes on. How many black brothers have fell victim to the streets and police? But life goes on. Last year, we poured out water for you. This year, N-word, life goes on. White solidarity is not supposed to last that long, but this person hates whites. Let me prove it more to you, even more. MLK is revered today, but the real king would make white people uncomfortable. Because King was apparently like a communist. Martin Luther King Jr. was a walking, talking example of everything this country despises about the quest for black liberation. And it says that behind where I'm talking, where you see me. And more and more people are no longer revering this poser. I remember I saw one clip on maybe Uncle Tom Part 2. UncleTom.com, JLP is in it. And he was listening to this woman's sob story, this poor black woman's sob story. And he's like, my. He was basically like an Obama, just a phony guy who like cajoled or charmed people. I gather. I don't know. I wasn't there. But he's like, my. like poor woman. Give me a break. Here's even more hatred. January 6th propaganda. I'll skip that one. This is the real kicker. Kyle, Jack Bauer, John Wick, Rittenhouse. This person wrote this. This Michael Harriet, who's bashing Candace Owens. That's our woman to bash. We bash her. Righteously. Not from the left, unrighteously. Kyle, Jack Bauer, John Wick, Rittenhouse. You know the alpha little young man? Not that little. Kind of fat. Portly. Wasn't convicted because in America, white reasoning rules. That's the headline to this person's op-ed article. When white people find black protesters scary and white vigilantes heroic, where does that leave the legal concept of reasonable belief? Huh? You mean reasonable doubt? It's a 2021 article. Maybe this guy's repented, but back in the 2020 riots in Kenosha, because this guy got himself shot because he was resisting arrest and fighting with the cops and allegedly had a knife, and they shot him in the back a few times. He survived, but he's paralyzed. We wish him well. But the evil Antifa people rioted. Not Christians. Rioted and destroyed businesses. And this relatively upstanding young man, son of a single mother, Kyle Jack Bauer, John Wick Rittenhouse, I call him, because he was so skillful in handling that weapon, did not hurt anybody who was innocent. No innocent bystanders, or if you want to call them innocent. They were out rioting for Black Lives Matter, dumb thing. They had no business being out there. He had business being out there because he was there to protect businesses. And that's what he was doing. And then he had to protect himself because he's like, shoot me, N-word. Little white, unchristian Jewish criminals were attacking him, physically attacking him, tried to take his gun, and he had to shoot them in self-defense. And it was obviously self-defense. from the video footage and all that stuff. Oh, but the some of the crowd here say there was a black guy who tried to jump him, a jump kick guy, and he fired in the air but missed him. See? White reasoning rules. By white reasoning, he means what? Innocent unless proven guilty? Belief in white people have the right to defend themselves against other not normal whites who attack them, who don't have any business being out there except to destroy and pretend like they care about black people. So, proof that this guy is a, you cannot reason with hate. He's right about that one. Here's his book, Black AF History. Sounds vulgar. I don't think he means America First. Michael Harriet. It just caught my eye. America's backstory is a whitewashed mythology implanted in our collective communist buzzword memory. Ridiculous. That's his book. I just read you this little blurb about it. So yes, hate cannot be reasoned with. Thank you, Hassan, putting those. I give him a ton of screenshots. It's ridiculous. Just caught my eye. Speaking of hate that cannot be reasoned with, I know I'm entering a phrase of the preposition. Anti-Trump MSNBC, speaking of lame so-called conservative or Republican females whom we get to bash righteously, but the liberals don't get to bash them. Well, they do. They revolted against Ronna McDaniel, that revolting rhino woman. Niece of Mitt Romney, the rhino who marched for Black Lives Matter, lame Mormon guy, whom I voted for him in 08 for the primary and then 2012 for president. Glad he lost. Clip 11 I have here, Hassan, if we can play this before I have to wrap up. I got this from Mark Dice, a fellow JLP fan. He played this from MSNBC, this woman who's bashing Ronna McDaniel. Because Ronna McDaniel is not sufficiently a Trump derangement syndrome sufferer hater. But Ronna McDaniel, no longer female chairman of the RNC. Has the RNC had a solid chairman in my lifetime? I don't know. They put this woman in there. But here's this woman, I think she pretends like she's a Republican. Think she used to be with Fox News, maybe. But now she's with MSNBC. What a downgrade, huh? Here it is.
Whether wittingly or unwittingly, is teaching election deniers that what they can do stretches well beyond appearing on our air in interviews to peddle lies about the sanctity and integrity of our elections, which Ronna McDaniels did yesterday at Meet the Press.
Sanctity. That's what caught my eye. It's just a portion that just caught my eye. My ear, I guess. My mind? Because I didn't see her say sanctity. Sanctity of elections. Sanctity. Normally they use the word, and I don't even necessarily believe in this, sanctity of marriage. Normally you think of sanctity of marriage or sanctity of something. Sanctity? What's sanctity even mean? Sanctity and state of quality of being holy, sacred, or saintly. Our elections are anything but holy, sacred, or saintly. Have they ever been holy, sacred, or saintly? Maybe marginally better when it was mostly white men and landowners, Christians, of good character, voting. And integrity. Oh, I believe our elections have a whole lot of integrity, of course, for the sake of my channel. That MSNBC lady is terrible. And I don't have her name. I sort of remember her from the Me Too movement, maybe? Maybe she was, like, bashing based Bill O'Reilly. I use the term loosely, but I still like that boomer. Shout out to the boomers. So, sanctity, election deniers, you denied the election, you denied us the election of our thing. We're mutual deniers. Well, I mean, the language that they adopt. These gals. They're still cute, right? Sort of. On the outside. Cute on the outside, dark and evil on the inside. Insufferable, says GMD Jim. Hake, why won't you read my super chat, asks Karen Williams. Shout out, Karen Williams. I don't remember you getting a super chat. Let me see. Oh, Karen Williams bought 5 coffees. Whoa, 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 whoa. Black, buckety. Black, people, black. Scrunch face, big smile emoji, sideways tear face emoji. Oh, I'm talking about the blacks a lot today. Is that what this is? Karen Williams, thank you for your 5 coffees. Whoa, that's awesome. What an honor. Shout out to the unhappy octopus, says Amazing Asia. I gotta end. We love you, Hake. Keep doing your thing. When you gonna share some more videos of you eating frozen GMO chicken nuggets in your car? and Popcorn Thumpcake, I'm gonna have to read your super chat later because I gotta end. And I gotta respond to your super chats more effectively tomorrow, hopefully. Joel Friday is coming up next, guys. Catch Joel Friday TV. And then, of course, American Anchor, baby. Enjoy The Hands of Men by 238. 238 Tuesday. All one word. 238. From the 2000 album Regulate the Chemicals. Adios, America. Bye.
Some people stay sick in bed, sick at work or in their heads. Doctors can diagnose problems they're having most. Regulate the chemicals, prescribe all the medicines, put you on the right road to recovery. Injecting you with peace of mind.
Peace of mind.
Sleep safely in the hands of men.
Do you trust your lives with to men or women, even worse?
Sleep safely in the hands of. Doctors to the patients, please have patience with the nurses. They ask too many questions, they give stupid suggestions. From the doctors to the patients, please have patience with the nurses.
This is why Hake is still single. It's Christian. .238, this is objectively bad.
And you don't need chemicals passing through your head.
You don't need chemicals passing through your head.
And you don't need chemicals passing through your head.
WT1, I'll have to read your super chat tomorrow. Rumble rant. Well, adios, America. Bye.